Very good morning, student. We are starting to the topic conic section. How can we define the conic section? We can take a chord. If a figure created when a double chord is cut by a plane, so when we are cutting a chord with the help of plane in different shape, we get mainly four figures. That figures we can give the name circle, parabola, ellipse and hyperbola. So how do we get circle? When a cone is cut by the plane perpendicular to the axis, to the figure which we get, that will be circle. Now we are coming on ellipse. How do we get the elliptical figure? When the cone is cut slightly, make an angle with the x-axis. So simply you can say the plane that intersect the cone is that neither will be parallel nor will be perpendicular to the axis of symmetry of the cone and cut through two sides. And the figure which we are getting, that will be ellipse. What will be the parabola? The plane that intersect the cone is parallel to an element of the cone. Hyperbola. The plane that intersect the cone is parallel to the axis of symmetry of cone. Axis of symmetry of cone means when we are cutting the plane, cutting the cone by the plane, then if it cut both the nappy, the figure which we get, that will be hyperbola. These are some different shape which we can see around us. As we are observing these different figures, that can be parabola, ellipse, circle, all these things. Now, we are introducing the circle. What is a circle? How can we define the circle? Suppose we have taken a point, that the point is fixed, and we are taking many points around that particular point, and we have imposed the condition that your distance of from this point always will be fixed. So we have taken many points. When we join all those points, the figure which we are getting, that will be circle. What is the standard equation of this? X minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square is equal to r square, where h k indicate the center of circle, r is the radius. If we open this, what we get? So we get, this is called the standard equation of circle. What do you mean by standard equation of circle? When we have some particular thing. So in this case, we will have radius and center of circle. So whenever we have center and radius, we can find the equation of circle, x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square. If we expand this, what do we get? We get x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. That is called general equation of circle, where the coordinate of the center will be minus g comma minus f, and the r will be under root g square plus f square minus c. Suppose we take some example. Somebody is asking, find the equation of circle whose radius is 5 and that is passes through the point 2, 3. So we have complete information. We are having radius and we have having center passes through that point. If we have passes through this point, so with the help of this we can get the, so we need what? We need center. If we need the center, so we can find that d with the help of these two points, and then we can use x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square. We have another example. Find the equation of the circle which passes through 2, 3, 5, 7 and minus 2, 4. We are required to find the equation of the circle. How do we find? Because in this case we are not having center, we are not having radius. So we have to calculate the center and we have to calculate the radius. So either we can use the general equation of the circle or we can use the standard equation of circle. Suppose we are doing this question with the help of the general equation. So we can assume, let x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0 is the required equation of circle. Here we are supposed to find, we are not having the value of g, we are not having the value of s, we are not having the value of c, because with the help of gfc, we are required to find the equation point of the center and radius. So we have assumed the equation, we have passed that our required equation of circle is passing through these three given points. So if it is passing through first point, second point and third point, we will have three equation in form of GFC. After simplifying all three equations with the help of GFC, we can find the value of GFC, and then we know that the center will be minus g comma minus f, and the r will be under root g square plus f square minus c. So we have center, we have r, so we can find the required equation of circle. Now we are coming very important thing. What is algebraic definition of conic? Because that which we defined earlier, what was that? That we are making the section with the help of plane. Now we are coming on algebraic definition. What is the algebraic definition? According to this definition, the ratio of the distances of the point from a fixed point and from a fixed line always bear a constant ratio. And that fixed point is called focus, and that fixed line is called directrix. So if we are taking any point, we have to take a fixed point in the plane, and we have to consider a fixed line in the plane. And we have imposed the condition that you have to take many point in the plane, but you have to follow one condition, that the ratio of the distances always bear a constant ratio. Now what happens? That d can be both equal. If ps is equal to pm, that is what e. E is called eccentricity. So what do you mean by eccentricity? So eccentricity is the ratio of these two d. So ps over pm, if is equal to ps or is equal to pm, then we get e is equal to 1. Our eccentricity will be 1. In this case, that figure will be parabola. Now, if ps is less than PM. If PS will be less than PM, then in this case, E always will be less than 1. If E always will be less than 1, in this case, that figure will be ellipse. If PS is more than PM, so in this case, we get E is more than 1. So in this case, that figure will be hyperbola. So with the help of E also, we can recognize the particular figure. That particular figure will be ellipse, or that will be hyperbola, or that will be parabola. Now, before starting the topic, we need to understand some important definition which will be used at every step. Now we are coming to vertex. First of all, we are coming on axis. So simply we can say an axis which is passing through the focus and perpendicular the directrix, that is called axis of the curve. Curve that can be parabola, ellipse or hyperbola. Now we are coming on vertex. What will be the vertex? Where the axis intersect the curve, that will be the vertex. And as we know, what is the focus? The fixed point is called focus. The fixed point is called focus, and the directrix, the fixed line, is called directrix. Now focal chord, as we know, if we are joining any two point on the curve, that is called chord. But now we are talking about the focal chord, a chord which is passing through the focus, that will be focal chord. Now if that focal chord is perpendicular to the axis, that is called lattice rectum. Now suppose we start the exercise on based on parabola. He's asking find axis, because in most of the question we are required to find the axis, focus, lattice rectum, eccentricity and the directrix of the following curve. We are coming on x square is equal to 16y. First of all, we have to recognize that our parabola will be on which axis. It can be on x-axis, it can be on y-axis. So as we know that a parabola is a second degree equation. So we have to recognize that the degree of y is 1 and degree of x is 2. So simply we have that it is y-axis. It is y-axis. And x square is equal to 16y because we have two cases. It can be x square is equal to 16y or it can be x square is equal to minus 16y. If it is x square is equal to plus 16y, then it will be upward parabola. I mean, it will go above the y-axis. If x square is equal to minus 16y, it will be downward parabola. It will go below the y-axis. So x square is equal to 16y. So in this case, first of all, we can compare the equation by x square is equal to 4ay. So as we know, 4a is equal to 16, so a is equal to will be 4. So as we are, he's asking axis, so axis is a y-axis. What is the focus? Focus, as we have calculated the value of a is equal to 4, focus will be above the y-axis and the coordinate of focus will be 0,4. And the vertex will be origin 0,0. Now we are coming on lattice rectum, it is always will be 4a. And eccentricity in case of parabola, e always will be 1 because the ratio was equal. Now we are coming on the another question, y square is equal to minus 32x. Here the degree of x is 1, so it will be on x-axis. Now we have to check it is a right hand parabola or it will be a left hand parabola. So negative sign indicate it will be a left hand parabola. So by the same procedure we can find the axis, focus, vertex and the lattice rectum. Now we are coming on the another question. He's asking, find the equation of conic if we have the focus and we have the directrix. So here we will use the algebraic definition. As we know, PS is equal to EPM. So first of all, we can consider a point P. P will be XY. And with the help of this point, we can find the PS. And then we can find the PM and PS is equal to EPM. That will be the required equation of the parabola. Now we are coming on ellipse. Find the vertex, focus, lattice rectum and directrix and major axis and the minor axis. So if we have the equation of ellipse, so first of all, in the main important point, we have to recognize the axis. It will be on x-axis or it will be on y-axis. So simply we can say if the component of x square will be bigger, that it will be on x-axis. If the component of y square will be bigger, it will be on y-axis. So as we are seeing our first question, x square upon 25 plus y square upon 36 is equal to 1. Then the component of y square is bigger. So we have seen that it will be on y-axis. So if it will be on y-axis, then the vertex coordinate will be 0,0. And the coordinate of focus will be 0, plus minus AE. And the coordinate of vertex will be 0, plus minus a and the center will be 0,0. We can make one important relation here. B square is equal to a square 1 minus e square. So with the help of this condition, we can find the value of a, b and e. In this case, we can observe that the value of a square is equal to 36 and value of b square is equal to 25. So by this, we can find a, b, e. Now we have another question. He is asking the equation of ellipse. If he is asking the equation of ellipse whose vertex are given, whose foci are given, to find the equation of ellipse, we are required to find the values of a and b. So vertex is given, so vertex is plus minus a comma 0, a is equal to 5, and the coordinate of foci is ae is equal to 6. So we can find the value of b with the help of that condition, b square is equal to a square 1 minus e square. Now we are coming on hyperbola. Here the pattern of the question will be the same. Find vertex, focus, lattice rectum. This equation almost will be the same. But equation of ellipse was x square upon a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1. In this case, hyperbola, the equation of hyperbola will, parabola will be x square upon a square minus y square upon b square. Here we have to consider which part is positive. Whichever part will be positive, x will be the same. So in this case, we are observing x square upon 25 minus y square upon 36. So x square part is positive, so x will be on x-axis. If we are observing the another question, y square upon 25 minus x square upon 49 is equal to 1. Here y component is positive, so x will be on y-axis. So by the same manner, we can find the vertex, we can find the focus, we can find the latest rectum, we can find the directrix, we can find the major axis. Major axis means the ellipse or hyperbola, whichever will be on that axis is called the major axis, and the another axis is called the minor axis. But in case of hyperbola, the major axis we can say the transverse axis, and the minor axis we can say the conjugate axis. Thank you, student.